Hello, hello! Welcome to another episode of Human Design Mini Lessons. Today we're going to be looking at human design and relationships, what each type needs. And today we are going to be specifically looking at the manifesting generator. So if you are in a relationship with a manifesting generator, this is for you. And then of course, if you are a manifesting generator, you can kind of look at this information. This is what you need. And it can be so enlightening and so beneficial to talk to your partner about your needs, to recognize that we are each different in what we need. Sometimes we end up assuming that, you know, because we feel a certain way in a relationship, the other person necessarily feels the same. And those are the kind of beliefs that end up being problematic because everybody has very different needs. So I hope this is very helpful for you. We're going to jump into what the manifesting generator needs in a relationship. But right before we do that, I want to introduce myself. My name is Trini. I'm a self-knowledge guide and human design specialist. And you can check out the links below for more opportunities to learn with me. I'll tell you a little bit more about those opportunities at the end of the video. But for now, thank you for being here. You can follow me on Instagram at Trini Human Design. And I post a lot of human design content over there as well. So if you're learning human design, if you're super into it, if it's helping you in your life, you can follow me over there. All right, so manifesting generator needs in relationships. The first thing that's important to know about the manifesting generator is that they need freedom to go at their own speed. If you don't know this about the manifesting generator, one thing that makes them very different from other types, even the generator, is that they go at a very different speed than everybody else. They move quickly. They sometimes skip steps. They kind of want to do things in their own way. They don't want anybody telling them how they should do things. And so it's important to give them freedom to do that and to go at their own speed and to do life the way that they want to do it. A lot of the times, manifesting generators will be kind of the epitome of doing life in a different way, of going against the norms. And you know, that can be hard sometimes if you are someone who has been taught that it's not okay to go against the norms. So it's important that you know that if you are with a manifesting generator, that they need this freedom, because if not, they're going to feel very, very encapsulated and the relationship is not going to flow well. Secondly, don't force them to go and do one thing at a time. Manifesting generators are meant to multitask. They're actually made for that. It's really good for them and it's healthy for them because they have a lot of energy. So it's healthy for them to put their energy into a lot of different things. Sometimes they'll do things that, you know, won't lead anywhere, and that's okay, but that could be very judged by society. So make sure you're not one of those persons that is judging them for doing so many different things. And for not, you know, getting success in all of them. They kind of need that trial and error process with a lot of their different passions or interests as they go changing, because that's what gives them information about where to go next. So make sure to be, you know, supportive in the way that they're leading their lives, the way that they're chasing passions and maybe also pivoting from one thing to another. They really need support in understanding that that's part of their process, that that's a perfectly good way to do things, even if it's different from other people around them. Then they also need to, you know, you guys both together need to work on informing each other. So manifesting generators, you know, they do better if they inform you. So you can tell them that for you, it's important that they inform you about the things that they're doing. It's not that they're asking for permission. It's just that it gives you more information and you know, it lowers the resistance of sometimes them going and doing something quickly and, you know, it being very impactful because you had no idea about it. But on the other hand, it's also good that you are informing them of how you feel, of what's going on, you know, in your household or in your family or in your relationship, because that also gives them peace of mind and gives them information about what to do next. Then it's important also for you, to not take their frustration or their anger personally. So as a manifesting generator, they're going to have two emotional themes, which just means that they're going to experience a lot of frustration sometimes when they're unaligned, but sometimes just when they're learning and they're in the learning process, and that's normal. And they also might experience anger when their creative force is interrupted in some way or another. So they might express this out. It's hard to deal with anger, especially in relationships, but it's important for you to understand that it's kind of part of their process. That energy needs to explode. Sometimes it needs to go somewhere. So the best thing you can do, the most constructive thing to do in a relationship, is to not take this personally, obviously, You can speak about what bothers you, but this is just part of the process. So giving the space to express the frustration, express the anger in healthy ways can be very helpful. Then they need to respond and be asked. So they are generators after all. They have that sacral energy, you know, ignited in them. And so they do very well with yes or no questions. They do very well with being asked this or that. So do you want to go to pizza? Do you want to go to sushi? Not about where do you want to go, because that's going to confuse them a little bit more. So ask them yes or no questions and, you know, give them things to respond to. Say, do you like this shirt or do you like that shirt? Make sure you're constantly asking them questions, because what this will do for your manifesting generator is that it will constantly be kind of taking them out of their mind, which can be very chit-chattery, it can be very noisy. And if you're asking them questions, especially yes or no questions, this is helping them tap into their sacral response. And so you're helping them get more clear about their life. You're helping them kind of also get rid of excess energy that they don't need, of kind of mind patterns and conditioning and fears that are always kind of running in the mind, that critical voice. You're helping them tap into who they really are and knowing, you know, with more certainty who they are and where they're going and what their life purpose is. It's also important to know that as a generator, they have fixed sexual energy, so they need practice to get things right in intimacy. And also, because they're a manifesting generator and they have that manifester part, they can be someone who's super independent, who can get things done on their own. And on an energetic level, this can mean that you feel that they don't need you. And that's because they don't. They really don't need other people in their lives. Energetically, they can make things happen for themselves. But that has nothing to do with wanting a relationship. That does not mean that they don't want to be with you, that they don't love you. So it's kind of like, if you get this feeling that they don't need you, not to take it personally, it's just an energetic thing, and that it has nothing to do with them choosing to be in a relationship with you or not. All right, well, thank you so much for learning with me. Again, my name is Trini, and I work with people and their human design charts to help them recognize who they truly are and expand into their next most authentic and abundant self. So one thing is to be able to, you know, get a reading, which is super cool, to understand your chart, understand the info, or even hear the info. But it's another thing to really be able to understand it and implement it into your life. It's really when you implement this information and start making concrete changes in your life where you'll actually start seeing changes. So one of my passions is actually working for extended period of times, and either 4 weeks or 8 weeks with people, to help them tap into and live their designs, to first, of course, understand what is it that their design is saying about them, but then to actually change things about their life so that they can live the design, enter the human design experiment, which is what we call it, and actually start seeing changes in their lives, which are actually changes that are so big, feeling so much more in flow, feeling so much more ease. So if that's something that you're interested in, check out the links below for sessions, for mentorships, and for more. Thank you for being here, and yeah, I love you. Bye bye.